for everybody. Like, even if it is the huge conglomerates versus the singular artist that's trying to cut it in the world, the importance of time management and actually managing your admin,
yes,
and even email management,
right,
it is so fucking critical. Like, none of us would succeed at our jobs, or even as an artist, if you're getting people hitting you up, even opportunities in your email box or whatever it might be,
yes,
if you're not on that shit, timely, responsive, knowing how to do it, and then just like working out how to manage your life 24/7,
yeah,
it's a thing. So when you're working in such a demanding ecosystem, you've got mm-hmm. staff, you've got all these big companies, you've got your bosses, just the company in general, how do you show up in an exceptional capacity and try and sustain that, like, reputation and delivery of service and the level of relationships whilst yeah. you're trying to respond to like the actual day-to-day like pool of administrative shit?
Yeah, that's also a good question. I think I always make sure I get up really early so I can have time to myself.
How is early?
4:45.
Oh my God. You couldn't pay me.
But I have to, because I need the morning to myself. I need to meditate. I need to work out. I need to think to myself. I need to like not have anybody calling me. I don't need to have any emails.
Yeah.
Even though people are emailing from other parts of the country early, but I can ignore them because they don't think I'm at work yet. So they know now that I'm saying it on here. But I need that time in the morning to myself. And that allows me to then get into my day. And then when I first start the day, I knock out whatever the major projects are out the way early. So I don't procrastinate a lot. That's one thing that's about me. I don't procrastinate. So because of that, I knock stuff out early. And then during the day, like, email is my last thing. Like, you do want to be timely and responsive, but I can't answer
24/7. You can't sit there.
I can't do that. Yeah, and because I won't get anything done.
It's actually very easy to get caught up like that, though.
Yeah, I take pockets throughout the day. Yeah, you easily can. Especially when people are emailing you about coming to a show, but they don't give you questions ahead of time. You have to like try to think about it. You know, people like that. Mm-hmm. But anyway,
you're annoying. Quit your day job.
Not letting email take over my day is just really, really important. But I mean, some days you have about a month ago, can't say the artist's name, but it was this major artist who's touring globally, and this person's manager, who I'd never spoken to before.
Adrian Miller, wasn't it?
No.
Kidding. Sorry.
Emailed me at like 6:30 in the morning. I don't know how they got my email address. From somebody, and basically was like, you know, we want to increase our, you know, tour and ticket sales in XYZ countries. We're not doing as well as we like. Like, when can we talk immediately? And I'm like, well, who's your promoter? Who's the agent? There's so many steps.
Yeah.
But those types of fire drills could easily like throw off your day, and you just like consume because you're like, man, I kind of want to work on it because it's the cool artist, but at the same time, I have other stuff I got to do. So like, just task oriented, put it in the right queue, send it to the right person, follow up, schedule time officially to talk about it. And like, I'm really protective of time, because time is the one thing that, you know, is the equalizer, as they all say. But if you squander it away, it's gone, and like, you can't get it back. So like, even in situations 100%. Like that, where it's like chaos or get all hands on deck, I still have to maintain, this is my schedule, I can talk at like 2:00. I mean, I have to be very diligent about how I go through my day in order to get things done.
You have to seriously, I mean, be like super skilled at decompartmentalizing your, not just time, but how you process information in your mind.
Yeah,
like,
not getting too hyped. People get, you know, really, really overexcited about things. That just throws them off for the rest of the day.
It's funny. I know, you know, really talented artists, for example, that are just effing hopeless at coming back on text or email or whatever. And you're like, that's why you've been independent for the last 5 years, because you haven't quite, your music might be dope, your social following might be huge, but you know, there's something missing.
Yeah.
Versus the younger emerging artists are like really accountable and responsible for their time and like whatever. And you know that in this day and age, with such a proliferated music industry landscape, with artists being able to be an artist overnight and achieve fame or whatever, like just visibility.
Right.
It almost doesn't matter unless you've got that 360 skill set of understanding the importance of how you can show up in the everyday world to, you know, respond and manage your time and whatever.
I totally agree. Also thinking about it from this sense too, like just showing up is hard for people to do.
Yes.
Like, do you think about the event that you came to where we met? Like, there were people I talked to afterwards that I gave advice to about various things. And I was telling them in that moment, I was like, you know, I don't claim to know everything. I'm just still learning like everybody else. But the fact that you took your time to come here, you didn't know you were going to meet me. You didn't know we were going to have this conversation. Mm-hmm. And hopefully that this this information can help you along in your career.
Absolutely.
And so that those nuggets of just, you know, showing up, being present, and like not squandering. That's back to my point about not procrastinating. Just showing up and being ready, because you can't predict how like any of like all my, just my journey or anybody's journey, you can't predict how it's gonna go.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
So the only way that you can be ready to receive whatever that next step is gonna be is by showing up, whether it's text and email, whether it's at an event, whether it's just how you present yourself when you're meeting new people. But that ability
to consistently do that. I hunted you down good, didn't
I? Oh yeah, you were out of control. but hey, I mean, at the end of the day, we wouldn't be sitting here having this conversation if you wouldn't have if you would not have done that. So it's important.
So you mentioned touched on the process and like ongoing management of decompartmentalizing in your head.
Yes.
And you referenced meditation. So have you studied meditation? Do you use it as a tool to sort of survive your everyday?
A little bit, but have you ever used the app Headspace?
I have, I practice a combination of Intuitive Buddhism, so I chant, but then I also practice Vedic meditation, which I've studied through a couple of different teachers, so I don't use apps like that, because I have my own practice and technique.
Yeah,
and my own.
So Headspace is pretty cool, because I mean, it's a guided sort of meditation.
Yes, I know it.
You know what, yeah.
So I've been
they've been one of our clients too. So I've been working with them, and through that, I kind of discovered
it. Will, aren't you too?
No, not at all. Honestly, I can say like I didn't use it at all. But it's been great just to take those, even if I'm not doing it guided with Headspace, but just the idea of taking those moments early in the day to like visualize like what I want to accomplish, getting your mind, your energy in the right place. I know it sounds real like spiritual, but it's really true. The days that I don't do that, the days I don't take the time to do that are the days that go horribly wrong. Those are the days that like I'm like probably ready to cut somebody out.
I think it's important to talk about it because you need balance. And I think everyone that's been highly successful and then crash and burn will come back and go, I'm now vegan. I don't drink anymore. I practice meditation and I now do not pick up my phone until, you know, 7:30 a.m. once I've done my meditation, spent time with the kids, cooked breakfast, gone for a run, whatever it might be.
Yeah.
So I think bit by bit human beings are becoming more and more spiritually astute to themselves and like really tapping in, and you know, you have to. So don't shy away from talking about that.
It's critically
important.
It is extremely important because you're gonna come in contact with people who are not doing that every day. So you have
who
to be
beasts.
In a good
Yeah.
You don't have to be a beast though. Like that's the thing.
No, you
like
don't.
A lot of it is just.
But there are still a lot of low oscillating human beings that are mentally, that is not quite evolved yet.
No.
They haven't quite connected with their ego and their like shitty behavior and how they're showing up to other people every day.
Yeah. I think one of the things
to experience a fair share of that in LA.
Absolutely true. Plus there's like two things, right? There's also like the idea of the music business and the history. If you understand the history of the business, do your research. There's just always been this like male machismo bravado, just yell, curse, throw things at people, just very
aggressive.
I
do that now
aggressive.
And I get great results.
They told me that when I walked in when you weren't listening. They told me all about you. The dog even looked a little scared too.
He's like,
Right. A little hyper. But yeah, like that's like been just the nature of like business. But what I think what helps keep me in the right place is that I've met a lot of people who are not well known to the public, who are like investors or who have started their own company and sold it to like some other major company, who are just living like the life of dreams essentially. And there's the chillest people in the world. Like, so like the most successful, you know, wealthiest people who had the most success end up being some of the most humble and down to earth people because they don't have anything to prove. So when I see people bringing that extra ego energy, it's just like, dude, I'm not
necessary. And I think the key, you mentioned the word balance, like it's just the balance is critical no matter who you are, what it is that you're doing.
Very true.
Like some of the most basic principles, such as be humble, have a balanced life, get up and make your bed every morning, have a routine with exercise and da-da-da-da-da.
Yeah.
You know, have a nice, consistent, spiritual practice, blah, blah, blah. Just achieving that through line of balance in all areas of your life, as basic as it sounds, it is so fucking critical to sustainable survival, you know what I mean?
I agree.
No matter what it is you're doing. If
Very
you're an entrepreneur at the top versus,
that's the bottom. I totally agree.
Yeah.